Yes, I remember Patsy.
The first time I ever heard Patsy Cline was when I lived in the state of Washington. And she had Walking After Midnight out. And she was on the Arthur Godfrey show. Do you remember that?
I sure do, yeah.
And this is right after she got married to Charlie Dick. Mm-hmm. And the Arthur Godfrey said, well, Patsy said, I heard you just got married. She said, yes, I did. And he said, well, are you happy? And she said, just as happy as if I had good sense. So I remember her coming on and singing Walking After Midnight right. and Your Cheating Heart. First time I ever met Patsy is about 8 months after I started singing, from 6 to 8 months. And, of course, I had started singing out on the West Coast. And when I come back to Nashville, I got on the Ernest Tubb Record Shop. And this was when Patsy had a car accident. And she had I Fall to Pieces was a smash record across the country.
I remember that.
And I love that song. So I got on the Ernest Tubb Record Shop and took one of these Country Song Roundup books and stood there and read the words off the Country Song Roundup book and sang I Fall to Pieces and dedicated it to Patsy. Well, she was listening in the hospital. She was in the hospital at that time from this car accident. And she sent her husband, Charlie Dick, into the Ernest Tubb Record Shop to pick me and my husband up and bring us out to the hospital to meet her, see? So here come Charlie Dick, and he said, well, Patsy sent for you. So me and Dew went to see Patsy. And of course, she was all in bandaging. Her face was bandaged up, and her leg was hanging from the ceiling, and it was just pitiful, you know? I couldn't hardly keep from crying. That's the first time I ever met her, and really, that was a friendship that was just last and last, never die, you know.
I tell you a little funny thing about that song. That was the first record that Patsy made after she came with our company, and she'd been under contract to someone else. And I had 6 different people turn that song down. And finally, Patsy did it, and she had a smile from ear to ear and said she didn't want to record anymore. She said that she just wanted to enjoy that one song forever because it was such a big hit. And that she said, really, I have to tell you this truth, said, the other side was the side that I liked. I really didn't like it either.
Well, I remember the time that Patsy had, when she had Crazy out, she got 3 standing ovations at the Grand Ole Opry. And they was standing when she left the last time, and she was crying.
Crazy was probably my favorite song that Patsy did. And we spent a lot of time making it. We spent about 4 hours on that one song, which was a long time in those days. And Patsy couldn't hit that note because her ribs had been broken.
Yeah.
And there was a note in it she couldn't hit. And so we finally just did it without her. And she waited 2 weeks and came back in, and she made it in one take. So the record you hear
something?
Is one take. But she really, I think she was really just hitting her stride about the time she did Crazy. I think that was really the height of her career.
Yeah, I think it was probably the one that she liked the most too, was Crazy. First time I heard this song of She's Got You, I was down in the floor waxing. I lived in Madison, Tennessee.
Yeah.
I hadn't been back in Nashville too long.
Uh-huh.
And I remember I had the radio sitting in the floor. And this record come on, and I told Peggy Sue, my sister was there with me, and I says, well, this is going to be a smash record. And it wasn't long till it was a number one. And this is one of my favorites. She never recorded too many fast songs. She seemed to always pick the slow ones because she could really put her heart and soul into them. Back in Baby's Arms is one of the fast ones that she did sing, and I really liked it. So I just had to put this on the album, too.
That's a good one. We used to have quite a lot of discussions about the fast songs because in the early days, Patsy used to like to yodel. And I didn't like to hear a yodel, and she thought that if she yodeled or growled real...
That was going
to
be country, didn't she?
Well, she had a real loud growl, which a lot of the girl singers used to use. She had a different kind of a growl. I guess it was like the old blues singer used to sing.
If you've got Leaving on Your Mind, this song, I'll never forget. When she come out of this record, she had come over to my house and picked me up, and we were going to Nashville. She was, in fact, she had ordered a bunch of long gowns, and this was back in the day, at the time, you know, that the country girl singers wasn't wearing long gowns. Now, Patsy was, and she had a bunch ordered, and they hadn't come in yet, but she went down to ask if they'd come in. And in the meantime, we were in her car traveling from my house to Nashville. And if you've got Leaving on Your Mind, was played at Weno Radio. They had played it out there, and it was her and Charlie had had a little fuss that day. So I told her, I said, well, look like you're leaving, girl. So we made a big joke out of it and had a laugh. I'll never forget, though, when we were in the car, she had her fingernails was getting longer. And I said, well, Patsy, how in the world are you getting your fingernails to grow out? Because I never could get mine to grow real fast. They'd grow, but they'd break off. Mm-hmm. She said, let me tell you what to do, gal. Put about 5 coats of fingernail polish on them, and they'll be stronger. So I tried that, but I could never get all the fingernail polish off my fingernails, so I thought, well, I'll just forget that. Do you remember cutting the last session with Patsy? Of course, you cut all of them with her, but Sweet Dream, she sang this song. It just makes you cry to listen to it now, you know. Well, she called me and do up Wednesday night. Well, this is right after she got through recording. And she wanted us to come over and listen to the session. So we got up out of bed and went over to listen to the session. She was all excited, you know. She was so proud. And she says, now I want you all to listen to this and see if you think maybe I'm getting out just a little too far. She didn't want to get too far out of the country feel, you know. But, of course, Patsy was 15 to 20 years, you know, ahead of her time, really, in her singing and the music and everything. Well, men do sit and listen. And we says, no, Patsy, it's beautiful. What else could you say, you know, because that's what it was. It was fantastic. Not that she had us come over and listen to the session. She gave me a whole big box of clothes. And she gave me some earrings, you know, and long, dangly, sparkly earrings. And so when I left, I had this big old box in my arms. So I went out the door, and I looked back at her, and I said, oh, dude, I forgot to say goodbye to Patsy. So I set the box of clothes down on the front of her Cadillac and went back in, and I hugged her and kissed her, you know. And she said, as I left, she hauled off and hit me a little bit and says, we're going to stick together, ain't we, gal? And this is the last time I ever seen Patsy.